Brazil, Russia, Indonesia. Three gigantic countries with large populations and economies. Now, you might be thinking, why on earth have we chosen these three countries? They are nothing alike. Well, that's exactly why. They are geographically, politically, and culturally completely different, but they are superpowers in their own regards. Hey guys, welcome back to the Geography Bible. I'm Sam, your narrator for the video. So in this video, we will compare them by their key demographics, economies, quality of life standards, and their geography. And of course, along the way, we will throw in some interesting facts. So let's first begin by looking at their geographical locations on Earth. Brazil is a country of South America that occupies half of the continent's landmass. Its capital is Brasilia, not Rio, which is commonly mistaken for. Russia, or the Russian Federation, is a country spanning Eastern Europe and Northern Asia. Its capital city is Moscow. And then finally, Indonesia, officially the Republic of Indonesia, is a country in Southeast Asia and Oceania between the Indian and Pacific Oceans. It consists of thousands of islands and its capital city is Jakarta. So let's begin by taking a look at their key demographics, starting off with their populations. So starting off with the least populated out of the three, we have Russia, with a population of 146 million, making them the ninth most populated country in the world, behind Bangladesh and above Mexico. Wow, that is actually incredible. Bangladesh is more populated than Russia. Wow. Next, we have Brazil, who are the sixth most populated nation on Earth, with an impressive 213 million people, putting them behind Pakistan and above Nigeria. And then finally, the most populated out of the three and the fourth most populated country on Earth, Indonesia, with around 273.5 million people, putting them above Pakistan and below the United States. Russia's population is growing ever so slightly at 0.4%, Brazil's at 0.72% and Indonesia's at 1.07%. Now that we know their population, let's take a look at their population densities. The lower here, the better in my opinion. Before we reveal this, which one do you think will have the most and which one do you think will have the least? So starting off with the lowest, we have Russia with just 8.4 people per kilometer squared. Next we have Brazil at just 25 people per kilometer squared. And then finally, the most densely populated out of the three, Indonesia at around 141 people per kilometer squared. However, the world's most populated island, Java, in Indonesia, has a population of a staggering 141 million people and a density of around 2,600 people per kilometer squared. So the island of Java is actually roughly the same as the entirety of Russia, just to put that in perspective. And now let's take a look at the life expectancies of these three nations. Spoiler alert, they are unfortunately all quite low. At 73.3 years, Indonesia has the 122nd highest life expectancy in the world, behind Venezuela and above Moldova. And then not so far ahead, we have Russia, at just under 73 years, making them the 113th highest in the world, behind Azerbaijan and above St. Vincent. And finally, the highest life expectancy out of the three, we have Brazil at a more respectable 76.5 years. Still not the greatest, and this puts them in 75th place, behind Malaysia and above Romania. When it comes to the average age of the population, Indonesia is the lowest at just under 30. And then we have Brazil at 31.5, and then Russia at 37 years. And to end this section, let's quickly take a look at each of these nations' most populated city when looking at their urban areas to make it a bit more interesting. So with by far the lowest, Russia's most populated city is of course Moscow, with around 12.4 million people. Next we have Brazil's Sao Paulo, who is actually the seventh most populated city in the world, with an impressive 22 million inhabitants. And then finally, the second most populated city on Earth, when looking at their urban area, Indonesia's capital, Jakarta, with an incredible 34.5 million people. That's over half of the entirety of the United Kingdom. Alright, so now let's move on to their geography. This one is seriously impressive. All three of these nations are gigantic, so we'll start off by looking at their total land size. Starting off with the smallest out of the three, Indonesia, with just under 2 million kilometers squared, making them the 15th largest country in the world, behind Mexico and above Sudan, to my surprise. This makes Indonesia the 4th largest country by size in Asia. Next we have Brazil, the 5th largest country on the planet and the largest in the southern hemisphere, with a staggering 8.5 million kilometers squared. This puts Brazil above Australia and below the US. Well, I learned something new today. I had no idea Brazil was actually larger than Australia. And then finally, the largest country out of the three and the largest country on the planet. We have Russia at a mind-boggling 17 million kilometers squared, meaning that Russia is almost exactly double the size of Brazil. Wow. The moon is roughly 38 million kilometers squared, meaning that Russia isn't too far off being half the size of the moon. So Russia takes up 11% of the Earth's total landmass, Brazil 5.6%, and Indonesia just 1.2%. Let's take a look at how much coastline these three countries have. Starting off with the lowest, we have Brazil, with roughly 7,500 kilometers. Only its eastern side comes into contact with the ocean, as its west is landlocked by its neighbors. Can you guess who is next? Which do you think has more coastline, Russia or Indonesia? If you said Indonesia, you are correct. With 54,700 kilometers, Indonesia has by far the most out of the three, with the vast majority of this nation being islands. And finally, in between, we have Russia, with 37,600 kilometers. Only its northern border really touches water, as most of its west and southern points are borders by land neighbors. These three countries are well and truly packed with forests. Brazil is home to the largest rainforest on the planet, the Amazon. However, astonishingly, Russia has more forest than Brazil and Indonesia combined. Russia is home to 8.15 million kilometers squared of forests, which is by far the most in the world. Next on the list is Brazil, with just under 5.2 million kilometers squared. And then Indonesia in 9th place, with just under 900,000 kilometers squared of forests. Now let's do a quick comparison of the tallest points in each of these countries. Mount Elbrus, located in southwest Russia, is the highest point in Russia and Europe. It stands at 5,600 meters tall. For Indonesia, at 4,900 meters high, Puncak Jaya is the tallest mountain in the southwestern Pacific. It is also the highest island peak in the world. And finally, Neblina Peak in the Imereir Mountains is the highest point in Brazil at just over 3,000 meters. Okay, so let's now move on to the economy and some financial statistics for these three countries, starting off with their GDP or economy size. These three countries are actually very similar when it comes to total GDP. Indonesia has the smallest out of the three, with around 1.15 trillion, putting them in 16th place above the Netherlands and below Mexico. And then with just under 1.5 trillion, we have Brazil in 13th place, putting them above Spain and below Australia. It's crazy to think a country of just 25 million people has a bigger economy than a nation with over 200 million. And then finally, the largest economy out of the three and the 11th largest on the planet, we have Russia with 1.7 trillion US dollars, putting them above Australia and below South Korea. Russia's largest export is crude petroleum, Brazil's is iron ore, and Indonesia's is oil and gas. Now let's take a look at the GDP per capita for these three countries. Starting off with the lowest out of the three, Indonesia, with roughly 12,300 US dollars per capita, making them the 99th highest in the world below Sri Lanka and above Tunisia. Next we have Brazil in 82nd place with 15,500, putting them above Serbia and below the Dominican Republic. And then finally the highest out of the three and the 57th highest in the world, Russia, with just under $26,000. Cool, so now let's move on to some quality of life statistics, starting off with their adult obesity rates. The lower here, of course, is the better. So Indonesia actually takes the clear win here, at just 6.9% of their adult population being classed as obese. Next we have Brazil at 22.1%, and then just above we have Russia at 23.1%. Now let's take a look at the pollution index for these three countries. The pollution index is made up of many different variables, such as air quality, drinking water quality, water pollution, garbage disposal satisfaction, and noise, as well as light pollution. So Brazil actually takes the win here in 42nd place, behind Poland and above Mauritius. Next we have Russia in 58th place, behind Malaysia and above South Korea. And then with the worst pollution levels out of the three, we have Indonesia in 71st place, above Hong Kong and below Kuwait. When it comes to the World Crime Index, Russia actually takes the win in 52nd place, followed by Indonesia in 74th place, and then Brazil with a very poor 126th place. And then finally, to end this section, let's take a look at which country scores higher in the World Happiness Index. So in 84th place, we have Indonesia, followed by Russia in 73rd place. And then finally, the happiest out of the three in 32nd place, we have Brazil. This was no surprise to me. How could you be sad in such a beautiful country? And finally, to end the video, let's have some quick fun fire facts about these three nations, starting off with Russia. So Moscow, Russia has more billionaires per capita than anywhere else in the world. Moscow has the third busiest metro in the world behind Tokyo and Seoul. St. Petersburg has three times as many bridges as Venice. For Brazil, Sao Paulo is the largest city in the southern hemisphere. Brazil has more animal and plant species than any other country in the world. And finally, Brazil has been the largest producer of coffee for the last 150 years. And finally, Indonesia. At 707, Indonesia has the second most languages in the world, only behind Papua New Guinea. Indonesia has the world's biggest young population, with over 165 million people under the age of 30. And finally, Indonesia is made up of a total of 17,504 islands. So now it's your turn. Let us know which one you would live in, which one you would visit, and which one you would avoid. And while you're there, let us know which cities or countries we should do next. I would personally live in Indonesia, Bali specifically. It caters well for Westerners, but still has that tropical island vibe to it. I'd visit Brazil to see their amazing nightlife, cities, and nature, and then I'd have to avoid Russia, although Moscow and St. Petersburg do look lovely. Now, if you enjoyed the video, a like would be much appreciated. And if you love this sort of content and learning about countries from around the world, be sure to subscribe. It's completely free. So thanks so much for watching, and we will see you soon.